Alright guys, so today we're going to be one of the first people I know who has received and will be installing the new Banks Power Ram Air Intake on the 2020 L5P. We got it pulled in the garage here. I'm going to show you what the stock intake looks like. There's the stock box. Not as ideally designed as it might be, but it's got all kinds of baffles and stuff in it. Drop down, got a resonator which will be going away. And this is what it looks like now. I'm going to go ahead and get it pulled off and put this Banks Ram Air on there and put it through its paces. I'm pretty excited because I don't know anybody else that has it yet. I haven't seen any videos or any posts. Alright, so as you can see, my current air filter life is 80%. I replaced it at some point, probably about 30,000. Got almost 1,300 hours and 51,000 miles. And generally, I keep my 8-gauge screen up here on the Banks data monitor, and usually that manifold air temperature is 176 right now at idle. Normally that's about, when I'm on the highway, between about 18 and 23 degrees, with an average probably around 20 over whatever ambient temp is. So that's something I'll be keeping an eye on. Manifold air density, I never really paid attention to. Boost, I've got a high record. EGT, I've got a high record I can refer back to. But really, I'm going to keep an eye on that manifold air temp and just kind of see to the pants, you know, how it feels. So let's go ahead and get started on removing the stock intake. Alright, so before we take the stock intake off, I want to kind of show you how the intake is boxed from Banks and what the part number is. Should be on here somewhere. So it's the 42266D for 2020 L5Ps. And I believe also the Super Duty is the same or similar. At least the air filter is. So this is the dry air filter. Had oiled ones, but usually they clog up the MAF sensor and you have to clean the MAF sensor a lot more than normal. So went with the dry. I will say that the dry filter is like $150. So that's more than twice what an SMB would be in years past. So I'm not real happy with the price on the replacement filter, but I figure we can get 35,000 to 50,000 miles out of one. I guess we'll have to see. Alright, let's get this open. Alright guys, prepare to smile. As always, Banks Power is great with their marketing. This is how it is packaged. Got a little bubble wrap in here. Let's see. That's essentially how it comes. So here's the new intake box, and this is massive. This is absolutely massive. You can see they got the filter taped in there. And we're going to set that down. Of course, you've got your instruction pamphlet here, which you probably won't need. I'll take a look at it. Right here is the elbow, or whatever they call this, the intake tube. Much smoother design than what you see with the stock GM unit. So that's nice. It's massive. Go ahead and set that down. And let's see what else is in here. Small parts. So there's all the bands, bolts, and I guess it's supposed to come with a sensor or something to defeat the MAF reading from the computer, which only reads up to a certain amount. So supposed to come with that electronic piece. I don't know if it's in here or not. Oh, there it is. Okay, good. Here's the elbow, which is absolutely massive. Only thing I don't like about it is that it's not really the same color black, and I think this might actually tarnish over time. You can see it's a little different, but it's rubber. It's heavy. And then here's the Banks air mass control module, which is what separates Banks from SMB, in the fact that you're going to have no check engine lights or anything like that. All right, let's go ahead and get this going. All right, guys, so to begin removing your stock intake, you're really only going to need what I'm using here, which is a long extension and an 8mm hex head socket, or you can use a Phillips, but the 8mm does both the Phillips and the flathead band clamp bolts. So there's a number of these screws holding down the lid. You're going to remove them all the way around and then start removing the band clamps. Let's go ahead and get to it. I'm going to try and film this while I'm doing it, just so you can kind of see where they're at. Okay. Don't take them all the way out. Just get them all the way out of the base. Let's see. Where's this one? Go ahead and get the rest of these, and then we'll pull it off. All right, guys, so I got all of the bolts that go around this top lid here holding it to the base, and I've already loosened up this band clamp here. So next step is to go ahead and remove your mass airflow connection. You just pop this red deal back here, push down, pull off, and then now I can grab this whole thing and pull it out. Oops. So that's the inside of the top of the box, which you can see. It's a fairly good size, but the design is not conducive to airflow. There's the stock filter, which is way smaller than the new Banks filter. And let me set this down. Let's go ahead and pull this out. Don't want to lose these. Okay. Here's the filter that I replaced probably 15,000 miles ago, maybe 10,000. I'm not sure. I'll have to go back and look. See how many miles are on this filter. It's fairly heavy. And now you've got the base here, which I believe is bolted down. I'll have to figure that out. So we'll pull the base out, and then we'll go ahead and start pulling out the rest of the tubing. All right, so from what I can tell, the only thing holding this base air box down is the 10mm right here. As you can see, some of these might take that, loosen it up. Then I can take it off by hand so I don't lose it. Okay, set that aside. And this should just lift right out. I think it's sitting on some kind of rubber dowel pins in the bottom. It might be clipped in. And then you've got this thing right here, which I'm going to pull out before I remove it. All right, so as you can see, I removed that one nut right there and was able to just pop this thing out. Now with this wiring cable, all you gotta do is just pull that out, just pull straight out. And now you can see there's a tube left in here, this plastic tube, for forced air on the front. You're gonna leave that in, I believe, because it's gonna fit into the air box, the new air box right here. So the next step here is we're gonna go ahead and get our intake tube and resonator off, which is just a matter of loosening up couple of these little band clamps and pop that out and get to the install. Alright guys, so before we get removing the rest of everything, I want to show you what comes in the plastic deal here inside the box. A couple of stickers for your fridge or the vehicle, and you get this one here that tells you to service every 50 or 100,000 miles sooner under extreme dusty conditions. Okay, that's good. Then there's insider news, registering your product, and then for the directions they actually give you a QR code and you use your phone's camera, and that will actually take you to a video or instruction manual which will show you how to remove and install. And then there's a little promo packet here which has all their other products. So I'm going to use my phone real quick just to make sure I don't take out anything I don't need to, and I'll show you what that looks like, and then we'll get to going on the rest of this install. Alright guys, so I use the QR scanner on my phone here just to kind of show you what these instructions look like. There's the part number. There's a video on how to do it. Here's the required tools. A couple of screwdrivers, some snips, and a couple sockets. Just kind of an exploded diagram of what it looks like. Removing stock intake. They tell you to remove the battery cables, which is a good idea. I just didn't do it. Allowing the ECM to discharge, removing the MAF sensor. Then there's one 13 millimeter socket bolt, which we'll get to here, so I'm going to get that ready. Then we loosen the two hose clamps. So I'm doing it a little bit different order than what they're telling you to. But eventually you do remove the stock box, as you can see there. And you'll remove the MAF sensor out of the box. Then you'll have to install some rubberized trim onto the new air box and cut to fit, which is why you need the snips. Take the mounting grommet off of the stock air box, install it onto the new air box. So you can scan through these when you're doing your own, but I'm just going to go back here to where we're at now, which is removing the intake hosing. And that requires a 13, so I'm going to get that. We're going to get going. Alright, so as it says in the instructions, there is behind the resonator a 13 millimeter nut. You're going to use a long extension, just like that. Pop the nut off, and then you can go ahead and pull the resonator out, which you'll have to loosen this 8 millimeter deal right there. Or you can leave it on and just loosen the band clamp down here at the intake bridge, which is what I'm going to do. Alright guys, so now I've got the 13 mil off, and I've also loosened up this clamp here. The airbox is already gone. You just grab this thing and wiggle it off. It's on there pretty tight. It's kind of welded on there because it's been on there for 2.5 years and 50,000 miles. It's never come off. So I'll have to put the camera down and wiggle it with two hands, and we'll get it out. Alright guys, so now I've got the stock intake off. Stock intake tube off, I mean. Here's where you can start to see the size difference. Look at that with the resonator and this intake compared to that elbow and that elbow going into the filter. I mean, it's just massive. Obviously much smoother and possibly a little louder. So we'll have to see how that turns out, but so far I'm very impressed. Alright guys, so the next step now that we got the intake tube out is we're going to go ahead and start installing the new intake. So we're going to have to remove this MAF airflow sensor using a T25 Torx, and then we are going to install it into the new intake tube right here using those same Torx. Alright Banks, if you're watching, or any of you guys, these instructions say to remove that MAF sensor from the stock intake using a T25. That is incorrect. It is a T20. The T25 didn't even fit. It was too big. This is a T20. And then again, I misspoke. Do not use the stock screws to reinstall the MAF sensor. Use the screws that come in this hardware kit with your new Banks intake. And they're in here somewhere, but I got to open this thing up so I can get to them. All right, guys. So actually, once you've pulled this sensor out, which this is what it looks like. This is your MAF airflow sensor, your MAF sensor. Once you've pulled this out, you should go ahead and clean it. Use some of the CRC Mass Airflow Sensor Cleaner. They sell it at AutoZone, O'Reilly, Napa, Pet Boys, whatever. So go ahead and blow out the MAF sensor, which I'm about to do here. I'll show you how that's done. And then we can go ahead and get it installed using these new stainless screws. It's these two little Phillips head screws. That's what you're going to use to install it in here into the new intake elbow. So essentially you just do this, kind of blow it out a little bit, you know. It'll evaporate, don't worry. Let me see if there's anything else here. Just blow the whole thing off, because why not? Yep. Can't hurt. So go ahead and do your best job cleaning it, and then we'll go ahead and get it installed. Alright, so the good news here with this MAF sensor and these new stainless screws is that this thing only goes in one way, so it'll actually slide in the other way, but the screw holes don't align up. But you want basically the way I've got it orientated where the connector is on the top side. When this is installed, they'll be on the top side. And I just tighten those up and we're good to go. So the next thing here, per the instructions, after you've installed that, so you're going to go ahead and install the rubber edge trim onto the airbox opening, taking your time to carefully work the trim into the corners. As you see here, you'll have to measure and cut. And we'll start in the middle of the outside portion. And then as you can see there, we're going to cut off the extra trim and leave a quarter to half extra inch. And we'll work it into the corners until we've taken up the extra material. Let's get going. Alright, here we are. And I've installed this edge trim. I haven't cut it yet, but this is the trim that you're installing and you need to cut a little bit long. So this thing is pretty stiff. You need to really work it in there until the edge is just over on the flat side and right up to it on the corners. So I've got it worked in there pretty well. I'm going to go ahead and measure probably about a 3/8 of an inch. Cut a little bit long, work it in there, and see if I can't make this gap nice and perfect. Alright guys, so I went ahead and squeezed it in all the way around and kind of just eyeballed it and got that forced in there, man. That gap is perfect. So I ended up taking off about a half inch. But we're good to go to the next step. Alright, so the next step here, as you can see, is we're going to go ahead and remove the mounting grommet from the stock intake and reinstall it on the new intake. And I'm not really sure, it's hard to see where it is, but let's see. Okay, there's the grommet, you can see. Alright, so we're going to pull that out, reinstall it on the new intake, and then we're going to go ahead and get it forced in there. Alright, here's the stock intake box, and you can see the grommet they're talking about. It kind of looks like it's hard to get out, but all you got to do is push this little metal sleeve down. And then there's like a thing on the bottom, so you just pull that out like that. Then you can go ahead and work this grommet out. I can even do it with one hand, maybe. Maybe not. Go ahead and pull that out, and we'll put it in the new one. Alright guys, so here's the stock intake box. I installed the new, or I guess it's the old grommet. Same orientation, you want the rubber side with the bevel up, and you force that in through the bottom, and then you force the sleeve in that way. So that's ready to install now that we got those two items in. So before you go installing it, you want to make sure there's a rubber grommet down here. You want to make sure that that's nice and seated. Same thing with this one here, that this is clean here because you're going to reuse the 10 millimeter nut. So let's go ahead and get this dropped in. Alright, so I ran into a problem, guys. I have a train horn on this truck and an air compressor, and so I have relays for it. The shop that installed the relays right where the airbox is. So when I went to install this bottom piece, these relays are hitting, and there's this ground here, so I'm just going to unscrew these and pull the wire over and mount them somewhere over there by the battery. But once I get those out of the way, I can get this thing dropped in. Alright, so I figured out where I'm going to put these relays. So the airbox sits in these two grommets and this screw here. And these relays have to be kind of in this area. And if I can get them right up against this wire, there's plenty of clearance there between the airbox and the relays. But over here where they were mounted before, there was no clearance. So just go ahead and put them right here. And then if there's ever an issue, I'll have to remove the airbox itself to be able to remove the relays and replace them, but that's no big deal. Let's go ahead and get them mounted and then I can put this intake together. Alright, so I wanted to show you how I cleaned up my relays here. So they used to be mounted over here. I painted the holes with touch-up paint, but what I did was I found the spot where there was clearance, I moved them over. Instead of drilling another hole for the ground, went ahead and used a weather pack or weather tight connector and with the heat shrink, went ahead and put it where a stock ground is. Clean it up a little bit and just get these wires out of the way down here. It should fit pretty good. Alright, let's get the airbox in. Alright guys, so we got the new Banks intake box, the lower half installed. You can see I got plenty of room for the relays where I put the relays. So if you have relays on your truck for a train horn or air compressor, let's scoot that back a little bit. Okay, so there's clearance everywhere. And I've got the screw or the nut 10 millimeter on there, and I made sure that the dowels on the bottom of this thing were squeezed into where they need to be. The only pinch point a little bit, which I'm not worried about, is my fuse link here to the, I forget what that is, probably to the air compressor, but sits down nice. Go ahead and use this 10 millimeter box wrench with a ratchet to go ahead and tighten up this nut. Let's see if I can get to it. Because you won't be able to get in here with a socket, so you just have to use 10 millimeter open end wrench. And so after I get that tightened up, we'll go ahead and get the rest of the tubing installed. All right, so now that we've got this tightened up in here, I'm gonna go ahead and install the air filter, get this MAF sensor out of the way, or the connection, drop the air filter in there, and then put the gasket on over it. All right, guys, so check this out. Look how big this freaking Ram air filter is. It is huge. They call it the big ass filter for a reason, and it is truly huge. Probably why it's $150. Put it next to a Coke can here for reference. Look at that. I mean, that is enormous. So basically what you do now is you just go ahead and, I'm OCD, so I'll make sure Banks is in the correct position. Go ahead and drop this in like this. Okay, sits down like that. All right, that sits down like that. So now once you've got it in there, you take this gasket, which is pictured in red on the instruction manual. Throw that on over top and let it sit down there. And then the next step is we're gonna go ahead and get the intake tube installed onto the intake elbow. All right, guys, so as you can see, we've got the next step here, and that is to install the number 88 and number 72 clamps onto this intake elbow. You can see it's marked on the clamp. The larger one is the 88, and the smaller one, which will go here, okay, and the smaller one here is the number 72, which you're going to go ahead and put on this end, and then you're going to go ahead and connect it to the intake hat. And we'll get that going because I can't film at the same time, but we'll do that and then we'll come back to this. All right, so we've got the 88 clamp on here, just a little bit snug just so it stays on. As you can see, there's a notch. So you want to line this elbow up with the hat. When you force it on there, it'll actually click. It'll snap into place, and then you want to make sure it's even all the way around before you tighten this up. Same thing on the back side, turbo side here. This is just on here just enough so it doesn't fall off, so that when we go ahead and install it on the turbo mouthpiece, we don't lose our clamp. So let's go ahead and get to the next step. So it tells you the same thing, the groove matches up, it'll click in. This is in proper alignment if it's not all the way up, but see, it's actually captured the dot here, so you know it's installed correctly. Go on to the next thing. Yes, it's correct. Now we're gonna place the lid over the air box and insert the 4/5/16 stainless bolts, just to hand tighten and get them on there while we go ahead and use a 10 millimeter socket to tighten those up. Then we'll go ahead and get the band clamp installed on the turbo side and start hooking up the electronics. All right, guys, so I got the turbo inlet pipe onto the turbo mouthpiece, which is here, and I just snugged down that 72 clamp with a 8 millimeter socket. It's on there nice and solid. I ran my fingers around to make sure that it was seated correctly. Same thing here, made sure it was seated correctly. Cinched up this number 88 with my 8 millimeter. And then the next step here is you're gonna go ahead and use the supplied hardware. It's these stainless steel bolts. They're using a 10 millimeter socket to tighten those down, but you just wanna make sure that your air filter is seated, the gasket's on there properly. Then you can go ahead and drop these in and get them tightened up. All right, guys, so we're almost there. We've got these four bolts tightened down now, and I did use a ratchet. It says not to. I mean, a electric impact, but just as soon as it broke the clutch, I let go. So these four are a little tricky to get started. You wanna start them by hand, obviously, and you're gonna have to manipulate this a little bit just to get into place, but it's nice and snug. This is a very well-made product, as always with Manx. Everything is like OEM, if not better. Next thing we're gonna do here is, here's our MAF sensor. We're gonna go ahead and plug our new deal from Banks in, which is gonna trick the intake into thinking that we're sucking in less air than we really are, and that way we don't get any codes. Let's go ahead and get that installed. Alright guys, so I've got the new Banks module in here for the mass airflow sensor. It's connected on this side to the stock sensor over here, connected to the MAF sensor. Now you want to make sure you seat it all the way and click these red tabs in, these locking tabs. Once you've done that, it's seated and it's not going anywhere. Then you want to zip tie it to this wiring harness to keep it away from this heat shield, because the EGR gets extremely hot. You don't want to melt or ruin the electronics. Once you've done that, you can move on to resetting the air filter life and driving the truck. Alright guys, the install is complete. Very easy, anybody can do it. Again, Banks makes super high quality products. That's why they're not always the first to market, but they are definitely the best to market. Got my zip ties cut, got this away from the heat shield. Everything's ready to go. Let's go ahead and get in the truck, reset the filter life, and we'll go ahead and do a review and test drive. Alright, so the last thing you need to do is reset your air filter life. So you're just going to toggle over here to information, scroll down, air filter life, press menu, and you want to hit reset. And then it's going to ask you if you're sure. You just say yes. There you go, 100%. Good to go. Now you can drive and enjoy your new Banks Ram Air intake. Thanks for watching, guys. I'll do a review in the next video.